Namaskar, hello and welcome to NCRT's live phone and interactive program. My name is Tanvi Khurana, and in this English session, we are going to discuss a topic which is how to understand while I read. Well, we all read languages, we all read English here and there, but do we understand, do we learn from them? That's the discussion we are going to have in this particular session. If you have any questions, any queries, please feel free to reach out. The number is given on your screens at the moment. It's 8800440559. So call us and ask your queries. You're watching us live on our YouTube channel, which is NCERT Official. In the live chat box, write down your questions, queries, and send them to us. You can even mail them. The email ID is dth.class9@ciet.nic.in. And you're watching us on PME Vidya channel number 9. Let me introduce you to our today's expert, and she is Miss Meenu Gupta. Welcome, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am. She is a mentor teacher from New Delhi. And let me ask her the first question, that ma'am, why did you pick this particular topic?
I chose this topic precisely because most of the times students feel that English is just limited to their textbooks. And if they are not reading the textbook, probably they are not dealing with English and probably they cannot learn English. So today I want to point out that you can learn English anytime, anywhere. There are so many resources around us from which we can learn a lot of things. And how to decode them, how to search for information while we are going through or having a look at those is what we are going to do today. That's the objective of the session.
Okay. So we can see that you have a presentation for our viewers. Would you like to show it to them?
Yeah, sure. So before we begin, let's understand what is reading. So reading is just nothing but it is a process of decoding sounds, words, phrases, sentences and their combinations to encode meaning to their immediate experience. That is, there are a couple of sounds, alphabets, words or phrases that the students read and then they try to pronounce them and then they try to understand what precisely those words mean. So that is called decoding. That already has a meaning attached to it. For example, if I say A for apple or apple for A, so in both the cases, there is a particular sound and a meaning attached to the word apple.
Right.
So if I understand what apple is, that's decoding.
Okay. And you said pronunciation. So pronunciation is also a part of understanding English?
Pronunciation forms an important part of understanding English precisely because the moment we change the pronunciation, in most of the cases, the meaning might also change.
Okay.
However, there could be words that have the same pronunciation and different meanings, but that would be going too deep into the language, which is not the purpose of this session. So okay. Moving ahead,
yeah.
So what's the essentials of comprehension? How do we, what are the important components of understanding English? So first thing I have already talked about is decoding, that I understand what is the meaning attached to that word. How do I read that word? Then there is sight vocabulary. Sight vocabulary is nothing but the words that are used most often while you are using a language, like a and the first. There could be n number of words that you come across in your daily life. So these are sight vocabulary. Then there is fluency, that you are comfortable while using the language. You don't fumble, you don't hesitate. You are very comfortable while you use the language. That's fluency. And then meaning. So these are four components of understanding a language, understanding or as you say, comprehension. So how do we actually look for material around us? In the beginning of the session, we have already talked about that language is not just limited to our textbooks,
right.
Specifically English. It's just not limited to textbooks. So where do I learn English? Apart from the textbooks, because due to COVID pandemic or due to various reasons, we are not going to schools, we don't have any access to various libraries or other resource materials. So how do I look for material around myself? So there could be posters around me on the walls, in the newspapers. There could be wrappers of things we use, including anything from chips to your dals, to your pulses, to your rice, to your biscuits. They all are a source of information for us. They are all a way to learn English. There could be leaflets that come with a newspaper, and most of the people just throw them without reading.
Yeah.
But they could be a very good source of learning language. Then there are signboards on the roads near you, outside your house, outside your street. Then there could be menu cards from the restaurants. Even they, in the newspaper, a lot of restaurants and hotels, they actually advertise through leaflets. And for online ordering also, you need those menu cards. Mm-hmm. So you actually go through those menu cards. You could find all these resources around you. I'm pointing out a few more. There could be doctor's prescription also could be a very important source. Then there could be pamphlets, greeting cards, bills, calendars, food labels, report cards, magazines if you come across them, school notice boards, shopping lists, or even recipes. You come across loads of recipes, or even if you want to try something new, we look at on internet, YouTube, or various channels. So even going through various recipes, we learn a lot about language. So these are some sources or resources which we find around us, and we can use them to search for information, comprehend the language, and learn more language.
Right.
Especially vocabulary. So on the screen, you can see a few samples. Can you recognize some of them, Tanvi?
Yes. So I can see a parking violation ticket.
Yeah.
I can see Aadhaar card.
Perfect.
Then there's a checkbook, a check.
Yes, it's a copy of a check.
Yes. And there's a is that a bank statement?
Yes. And that's a bank statement.
That's a railway ticket or a
airplane
ticket.
Yeah, that's a plane ticket. So these are some things that you come across, right?
Yeah.
You could have seen them, and then we just ignore them. We don't pay attention to them.
Hmm.
And this is precisely what we need to do. We need to pay attention to what is coming across all of us.
So you're saying that once we read these things, we'll understand them as well?
Yes, once we read them, we pick up the specific vocabulary. This is how we increase our vocabulary bank. We all have an active vocabulary and a passive vocabulary. So active vocabulary is something that we come across in our daily life. We use them, we understand them.
Hmm.
So this is how we actually increase our vocabulary bank, and we increase the number of words that we can understand and use.
So there are times when we read something, let's say a parking ticket, and there's a word which somebody isn't understanding or isn't able to pronounce properly, then they simply skip it. They don't read it again, they don't make efforts and read it again. So in that case, what does a student do?
In that case, actually what we need to do is, nowadays everything is in your hand. You just have a mobile phone and then you have the world in your hand. You just need to put it in the Google. Put that word in a Google. It will tell you how to speak. It will tell you the meaning. It will tell you how to use the word also in different contexts.
Right.
So just a 1 second effort, in fact. You don't even need to put the complete hand spelling. It will come in the options also. So that just 1 second or 5 second effort will actually add to your vocabulary. This is what we need to know.
Okay.
Because taking an easier route is always easy, but just a little effort helps you a lot.
Yes.
So let me go ahead. So there are checks, recipes, as we have already discussed in our slides. Now these are a few more. Can you guess them, Tanvi?
So the first one is the causes of global warming. It's kind of a poster.
Yeah.
And then a rock for a cause. It's some announcement about some event.
Yeah, it's sort of a pamphlet or a leaflet that comes to announce an event.
Right. And the other one is by United Kingdom, if I am reading it correctly.
United Nations. Yes, it's just a advisory that comes, that was very popular in past 1 year. COVID has wreaked havoc with our lives, and this is a sort of a advisory that has been released by the WHO.
Right. And then there's a Unity Day poster.
Yeah.
And then there's just a quote.
Yeah, motivational quotes.
Right.
So everybody's good morning messages, good evening messages, festival messages, they are littered with motivational quotes. What do we do with them? We just read them once and then forget.
Hmm.
And if it's very beautiful looking, then we might forward it to a few people. That's all we do.
Yeah.
Do we actually take out time to pick out words, to understand the words that are written there.
Hardly anyone does that.
That is what needs to be done. Like what I do is, when I was growing up, I still remember my grandfather, he used to pick out two most difficult words from the newspaper. He was an ardent newspaper reader.
Okay.
So he used to pick up two most difficult from the newspapers and then he used to tell me, find the meaning. Then I used to take out that Motawala dictionary, that thick one.
Yeah.
Go through the words, look for the meaning, tell him the meaning. Then he used to tell me, write sentences also for them. Then I used to write sentences for him. This is how actually I give a lot of credit for my English to my grandfather.
Wow.
So this is something we don't all need a grandfather. This can be done by ourselves also. It's all self-motivation. So if I want to learn English, I think I can do it.
Right. And when I was a kid, I remember my parents used to tell me, you have to read the newspaper, and because it definitely was difficult as a child. So I used to pick like two pieces, any of the two pieces, and then read it out in front of them.
So that's great. So a little effort actually helps a lot.
Yes.
So let's continue.
So these little things here and there, they are going to help you understanding the language. So just pay attention, like ma'am said.
Yeah, these are what? So we all see them.
Yes, these are signs.
Yes, these are such as signboards or billboards that you see, like just looking outside your bus, your car, your bicycle, driving on the road, inside your streets. We all find such signboards.
Everywhere.
Everywhere. So these are also a good source of information.
So when it says that welcome to RIST, we speak English, the spellings are wrong here. And if I have that fire in me, then I'll say that no, the spellings are incorrect here.
I have specifically used this image to help catch your attention. Sometimes if everything is correct, we don't pay attention. But if something is wrong, we definitely pay attention to point out the mistakes. This is one way of catching attention. So if something like this catches your attention, do pay attention. So these are signboards. So while paying attention, what we need to keep in mind. So WH questions are Ramayana and Mahabharata, you can say Gita, anything you can understand. Like it is to go or pay attention to. WH questions, who, that refers to a person. What refers to a specific information. Where refers to a place. Why refers to a reason behind a phenomenon or an information. And when would refer to time. Sometimes I have not written one question how here, because in small leaflets or pamphlets, sometimes how is not focused. How is basically used when we need to know the process, and process is only pointed out in a recipe. Otherwise, these information resources that I have already pointed out to you, they don't use the question why. So these are five questions that we need to understand or pay attention to. So can you just repeat them for the
Yes, I'll do that. So WH questions, who, what, where, why, and when.
Perfect. So who refers to a person, what refers to a specific information, where would refer to a place, why would refer to a reason, and when would refer to time. Now let's try and practice what I am talking about. Can you guess what this is, Tanvi?
That's a railway platform ticket.
Precisely. We all have traveled in railways. So
yes,
this is a railway platform ticket. So do you think I can use this to understand or seek information? What kind of information do you think this ticket offers?
That this is valid for a particular place.
Yeah.
And for a particular time.
Very good. Anything else?
And the reason as well, that why?
Of course, because it's a platform ticket, so you can enter the platform only if you are carrying this ticket. So the reason is inherent. So let's try. The cost of the platform ticket is, so I'll go back to the ticket.
10 rupees.
Perfect. So she can look for information and pinpoint. How do you know this information is, like, this ticket is 10 rupees?
It's mentioned on the ticket.
Yes, rupees 10. Hmm. Then name of the platform is, now, do you think you can guess the name of the platform?
Railway platform.
See, now how do we search for information in case we are not able to gather where the information is? If I am saying name of the platform is, so the keyword here is platform. Now let us see where these words platform have been written in the ticket. So you can see it in the, I think, second line.
Yes.
And then the third line.
Hmm.
So before the second line only rupees 10 has been mentioned. Hmm. However, in the third line, what's written? Hazrat Nizamuddin. So it's the name of the railway
station.
Platform, railway station, where this ticket has been issued. So this is how we search for information in something which we are not, which we have not used before or we have not come across before.
Okay.
So moving ahead, the next question, Tanvi, ready?
Yes, ma'am.
So the date of the issued ticket is, what's the date? Can you check?
It's 2,
yeah,
4,
perfect. Yes, 2016. Nowadays, railway is on a break due to COVID. So this is the time, date of the issue of this platform ticket is?
2nd April 2016.
Thank you so much. And this ticket is for how many persons? How many people can use this ticket?
Two persons. The last line, one person.
Yes.
One person valid for 2 hours only.
Yes, exactly. So one person. How did we decode this information? Was we looked for the keyword, that is person. We went back to the image, looked for the same word, person, and then we could find the number one across it.
Right.
So this is how we search for information in a new resource. Now let's try more. What's this image? Can you?
That's the metro map.
Yes, that's a metro map. Nowadays it's the most popular means of transport and most loved one. In fact, I love it because if it's like very convenient to travel long distances in a very short period of time.
Right.
So let me ask a few questions from you. Name any two stations falling on the yellow line. Can you see the yellow line?
I can.
So great. Can you name any two stations on those yellow line?
Yeah. The first one is Lok Kalyan Marg and then followed by Jorbagh.
Exactly. So I think even our students would love to play this game.
Yeah.
They can also try the answers and write them to us in our chat box.
Hmm.
So there are a few more that you can even mention, South Extension or AIMS.
Right. South X is on the pink line.
Exactly. Thank you so much for pointing out, Tanvi. Now, moving on to the next question. Name the color of line 6. Can you see the line 6 written somewhere on the image? Should I give you some more time to go through it?
No, I can see it. Line 6 is the black one.
Yeah.
Though it's not originally black, but here it's black.
Here it's looking like black,
yeah.
But it's supposed to be violet line.
Right.
Poor image. Sorry. So, name the station having a plus sign. What does plus signify, Tanvi?
Medical.
Medical. It could be a hospital, it could be a chemist, it could be any medical resource that is available. So, can you tell the name of the station?
AIMS.
AIMS. Great. What is the name of the mustard line?
Mustard line.
You can even say it's orange or mustard.
Okay. So, Durga Bhai, no, that's the station, the line. I'm unable to read the line.
Okay, it's Airport Express Line,
okay.
No problem. Then name, now this is the most difficult questions. Now you have to pay very detailed attention to the image. Name all the stations falling on the pink line.
Okay. So let's begin from one corner. If I'm not wrong, Delhi Kent.
Mm-hmm.
Then Durgabhai Deshmukh South Campus.
Mm-hmm.
Then Bikaji Kama Place.
Okay.
Sarojini Nagar.
Excellent.
South Extension. INA. In between these two, INA.
Yes.
Then South Extension. Then Lajpat Nagar is, I think, it's on both the lines.
Yeah.
So we can count it on pink line.
Yeah. So this is a map you could have found displayed in all the stations across various places in a metro station.
Right.
So this map is also used for seeking information. So unless and until you try reading them, unless and until you pay attention to them, it would be very difficult for you to reach a particular place. In case you don't know where, how do you have to approach the place? So now, what is this? Can you guess?
Absolutely, that's a menu, a restaurant menu.
Yeah, that's a restaurant menu. Now I have a lot of difficult questions from you. So, can you see the image?
I can.
So, the first question is very easy. You have already answered, Tanvi. You can see a dash on the screen. What's this?
A restaurant menu.
Yeah, a menu card, a restaurant menu. Perfectly, okay. Now, name any two heads of food seen in the menu. Any two heads would work.
Any two heads. So, salad and soup, veg.
Right, great. So, there are a few more. Thandai, there are salads, papad, soup, veg and
soup non-veg.
You can choose any two. Now, the difficult one. The cost of the hot and sour soup is?
I'm unable to read. Nah,
because the image is pretty small. So, it is. I think the viewers might be able to see. If they are on the phone, they can just extend the screen and see. It is rupees 110. Now, this is the question for the viewers. I am leaving it for them. Because the menu is there with you, you have the image, you have to plan a small meal for me under rupees 220. But the catch is, the meal should include a salad, a papad and a veg soup. So this is a question for you. You can try it for your homework.
Okay. Even I would like to try it.
Yes, you want to try. Okay, Tanvi wants to try it. Can you try Tanvi?
Let me try it later on because we don't have much time left.
Okay. So, while we read, let's understand what we need to do. What is the process of reading? I need to predict, that is to use clues to infer what may happen. Sometimes, what we have talked about earlier are some resources that have very little information. Like a platform ticket has very limited information or a metro map has very limited information. But there could be cases that you have to read a bigger amount of information, like a paragraph, a newspaper report, or even your chapters or text or unseen text in your comprehension. If you remember, class 9 actually has 3 comprehension texts, unseen, and then there are 2 comprehension texts seen that come.
Okay.
So, we need to decode them and for faring good marks, what I need to do is predict, that is use clues to infer what may happen. Connect, that is I have to connect it to my previous knowledge, what I already know about that thing. Then infer is use clues, what I know to make sense of what I am reading. Then I need to pay attention to the questions that are being asked.
Okay.
So, what we do is sometimes we read the questions first and then we go back to the text to save time.
Okay. So, ma'am, can we leave the rest of these sentences and understanding for the viewers? And we'll leave them with this and maybe we'll take it up in the next session?
Yeah, sure. But one thing I would like to say, please read whatever you come across. I have pointed out few things to you. So let's read across whatever we come across and see whether we can decode this information or not.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
For this catch, because we generally skip this important portion. Thank you so much. Thank you to all the viewers for watching this session. But before wrapping up, we have a very important information for all of you regarding Rashtriya Kala Utsav. 1 से 12 जनवरी 2022 तक आप देख सकते हैं और स्कूल शिक्षा और साक्षरता विभाग द्वारा शिक्षा मंत्रालय भारत सरकार की पहल पर एनसीईआरटी के सौजन्य से 1 से 12 जनवरी 2022 तक कला उत्सव आयोजित किया जा रहा है। जो नीचे लिंक दिया गया है, आप उसके माध्यम से जुड़कर इस कार्यक्रम का आनंद ले सकते हैं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए। थोड़ी देर में हम हाजिर होंगे अपने साइंस के कार्यक्रम को लेकर और उसका जो टॉपिक होगा वो होगा टिश्यू। तो अपने सवाल तैयार रखिए और देखते रहिए पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स। नमस्कार।